tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Dust Countdown. Sean Locke, John Richardson, Jason Manford, Rod Gilbert, Danny Dyer, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now welcome your host, Jimmy.
To 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, Countdown was originally a French format. France's Countdown is exactly the same as our Countdown, except at the end of the game, the clock goes da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Countdown's been sponsored by Vitabiotics, Specsavers, Seven Seas, I Believe Gel and Kellogg's All Bran. You've got to hand it to the makers of Countdown. They're doing their best to keep their audience alive. And the longest word composed entirely of letters from the first half of the alphabet is the 12-letter word fiddle-dee-dee, as used in the sentence, I went out on a date with Dee-Dee, we went back to mine, and I proceeded to fiddle-dee-dee. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet our players tonight. First up, it's Sean Locke. Yeah, Sean Locke, our little ray of glumshine. Sean is as happy as Larry. Unfortunately, Larry's bipolar. And his teammate this evening is Jason Manford. Jason used to be a team captain on 8 out of 10 Cats. If you're wondering where he comes, he's the one after Dave Spikey and two before the one who's going to replace John Richardson. If Jason wins tonight, the people of his hometown, Salford, will celebrate in their traditional manner by climbing onto the roof of Strangeways and throwing tiles at the police.
That's us Thursday.
Lovely to see.
Nice to be back.
OK, up against them this evening is John Richardson. In 2011, John released a book about his quest for love. Before it, he hadn't had a girlfriend in 8 years. And after, he's not had a girlfriend for 2 years. So, some improvement there.
The joke's on you, Jimmy, because I have got a girlfriend.
Well, she must be made up.
She's blown up, to be honest.
And John's teammate, Rod Gilbert. In 2010, Rod was named Wales' sexiest man. Nice for Rod, but a real kick in the teeth for Wales. Sean, what would it mean to you to beat John this evening?
It'd be like finding a fiver in an old coat.
Jason, is it nice to be on Sean's team? Because you were obviously...
Yeah, I was always on the other side, so I don't know why people were always crying on this side. Hopefully I'll find out today.
Well, actually, this is quite a momentous moment because... I think a lot of people can take as a lesson here for everybody is because I used to be pitted against... We were sworn enemies week in, week out.
Sure.
Now we're together. And I just hope the people of Israel and Palestine are watching this and they can take something from it.
Have you got a lucky mascot this evening? What's that?
Yes, I've got my... Squaresy, we call it. I go to bed with it, and it's just, I find it very comforting to have near me.
Can we have a look at that? What?
No, it's just a square little friend. And whenever I go cycling, I take Squaresy with me.
Does he talk to you? Does he give you encouragement? What's...
He gives me little help during the show. Little bits of help. He's very shy. He'll only give me help under the desk. A little bit of help under the desk. I go under the desk, go, Squaresy, a word. And Squaresy comes up with words. You're fine with that, are you, John?
Yeah, he seems to have sort of weird intestines that have sort of got words written all over them, his intestines. That...
Yeah, well, I didn't know it was a dictionary when I bought it.
Now, John, have you got a lucky mascot of any description?
Well, I have, yeah. Well, it's not really a mascot. When I was at primary school, I got given an award just for being extra special. I've kept it all these years. It says, awarded to John Richardson for being extra special.
Why did they give that
to
you?
Yeah, what was it for?
Well, it's for being extra special, man. 20 years. Look how good nick that
is. That is a good nick.
Did you ever wear the badge, or has it always stayed on the...
No, I've never taken the badge off because I didn't want to perforate the card.
There's a man that's living life to the full. OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Danny Dyer. Danny is actually here this evening researching his new show for Bravo, where he attempts to find Britain's hardest conundrum. Are you a fan of Countdown?
No. it's like my dream. I don't know. Sitting here like this Dictionary Corner.
It's more of a dream for us that you're in Dictionary Corner.
And with Danny, of course, is Susie Dent. Yes, Susie Dent. If you look up elegant, sophisticated and charming in the dictionary, then Susie Dent will tell you to piss off, because looking things up in the dictionary is her job. How does the Cats Countdown, how do these Motley Crue compare to the normal Countdown competitors?
I can honestly say that these guys, especially John and Sean, are as good at Countdown as normal... Well, in fact, the champion Countdown contestants are at comedy.
I genuinely thought for a second that was...
I got the conundrum in, like, half a second last time. Has that ever been done before? That quickly? Come on.
Never.
You ever seen anything that quick?
Never.
Yeah, but that's just probably luck, isn't it?
How could it be luck?
Well, it can be luck. Sometimes a load of letters appear in front of you and then they make sense.
Well, how would you call
that? That tends to be when...
That's reading, isn't it? Isn't that reading?
They have a Welsh language countdown.
They don't have a Welsh language countdown, no.
Another L. Another L.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. If Rachel Riley's so good at maths, how come whenever I ask her, she can't even remember her own telephone number? Well, tonight our teams will be competing for this, the coveted Countdown teapot. OK, everyone, let's count down. Time for the first game. Sean and Jason, you're to pick the first lot of letters.
Can I get a T? And a H?
I've written that down.
Go on, you've done this before. What do we pick?
It's hard. It's really hard.
Damn it! Let's go consonant.
Start with R.
And then a vowel.
I.
And then a consonant.
N.
Oh.
And then
something.
Another consonant.
Please be G.
T.
Rint.
Rinse, that's a tear in a cape.
It's an aromatic cape.
It's also what they have to pay every month in South Africa or they get evicted.
I'll have a vowel there, please, Rachel. Can you put a vowel
that's
up there?
Extraordinary, John. You make everyone do a South African accent in their heads. It's an incredible skill.
Another vowel, please.
E.
I'll have a consonant, please.
R.
What's that? How many have I got left?
Two more. It's the two spaces.
I reckon another.
Another consonant.
Rachel, stop patronising.
And another vowel.
And the last one. U.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. OK, what have you got? Sean, Jason?
Four.
Five.
Four, five. John?
Five.
Rod?
Oh, about seven, I reckon.
OK, Sean, what's your four?
Rint.
Jason, what have you got?
Truer.
Guys, I don't want to hurry you, but I'm sitting on a fucking seven. Any idea how this feels? It's a possible eight.
John.
Well, I just add inter.
Susie is.
Yeah, to bury somebody, to inter them.
Rod, what
well, I've got a definite seven, right? Possible eight.
Ooh. Okay.
Now, how do I play this, Jimmy?
Definite seven.
How do you play this?
Yeah.
You've got to give us a seven, because you said seven.
I'm going to go for the seven, a definite urinate. But then, see, I would argue the possible eight is if you said, who's that urinator over there?
The very first meeting of a urinator was a diver. But it's not in anymore. I can't believe it. It's not
in anymore.
So, Rod, the good news is you get 7 points.
Well done.
Yeah, urinate. Brilliant.
I could have been there, Danny.
Well, I smashed it, mate. I've absolutely smashed it.
What have you got?
I went with a trainer first.
He had that within, before all the letters were selected, he had trainer.
And then I've got. Tenure wheel.
Brilliant.
What's
Tenure wheel.
Fantastic. Oh,
what word is he trying to say, Susie?
He said it. Tenurial.
Oh, and tenurial means?
Brilliant. It's all to do with the tenure of land, the holding of land.
Yeah.
How did you know that?
I don't know. I'm clever bollocks, isn't I?
Okay, you just watch the language in front of Susie.
He's all right. She's bang on.
Yeah. He's used to talking to posh ladies like that when he's with his solicitor.
OK, well, let's have a quick look at the score. So, at the end of that, Jason and Sean have no points. John and Rod are in the lead with seven. On to our first numbers round. OK, John and Rod, go ahead and pick your numbers.
What do you like?
I genuinely don't know what I'm supposed to say. I've forgotten how to do it. What do you do? Oh, yeah, one big one, yeah.
One big one, five small ones.
One big one and five little ones.
All right.
All right, first one's 10, 7, 4, 5, another 4, and the large one, 100. And the target to reach, 579.
Your time starts now. Right, John, Rod, did you get it?
I've got 576.
576, OK, three away. Rod, did you get it?
No. I didn't get it, no.
OK, Sean?
It's just not...
Yeah.
Didn't happen, the magic didn't happen.
Jason, did you...
I've got 578.
Let's see how you did that, the 578.
100 times 5.
100 times 5.
I didn't say the 100.
God, I'm kidding. I didn't see the 100. I've got 5.
Are you joking? This is impossible. I wrote 579. I went, it's impossible.
Go on.
7 times 10.
7 times 10, 70.
And 4 plus 4.
4 plus 4, and add them together, 5, 7, 8. One away, well done.
So 7 points to you. Well, and one away. Is there any way on God's good earth that could possibly have been done?
I'm not sure on this one.
I've just got it.
What?
You got it?
I think so.
Go on, then.
Oh, no, I haven't.
Hang on, there's a man in the audience that thinks he might have it.
7 plus 100.
Oh, there it is. Yeah, yeah, yeah. OK. 100. 7 is 107, and times it by 5 for 535, and then 4 times 10 is 40, and add that in the other 4. You get 579.
So just to recap the scores, at the moment, Sean and Jason have 7 points, John and Rod have 7 points, and the man in the audience has 10. So, OK, it's time now to go over to Dictionary Corner. Danny, your use of English is kind of, you know, you're known for it. You're known for using English in an interesting way. What's your favourite word?
Xylophone. Right? That's it, clap it.
How good was that? Someone in the Countdown audience. Woo! Xylophone. Oh, come on. Why do you like xylophone?
What, because it's got an X in it? And, oh, discombobulate, that's a good word. Eat it, have a look, eat it.
That's N.
It's in there,
isn't
it?
It's called.
I don't know what it means at all. It means to me if you're a bit confused.
It's good, it's called tamesis, that. Good use of tamesis.
I love her.
What's called
tamesis? Tamesis is when you put something in the middle, like... what did it do?
OK, here's your teaser. The words are hard semi, and the clue is not always easy to grasp. That's hard semi, not always easy to grasp. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were hard semi, and the clue was not always easy to grasp. It was, of course, misheard. OK, time to mix things up a bit. You've been playing in teams so far, but this letters round is for Sean and John only. So, John... your turn to choose the letters.
Hello, Rachel.
Hi, John.
Can I have a consonant, please?
You can, thank you. Start with N.
What was that? N.
N.
T, that was. And a vowel, please.
Q.
I. And a consonant, please.
7.
And another vowel, please.
The concept of space.
E.
Weird selection this time, isn't it? and another consonant, please.
Exam.
D.
And a vowel, please.
No.
And a consonant, please.
B.
And another consonant, please.
S.
And a vowel, please.
And the last one. A.
And your time starts now. Sean?
Fives.
Fives.
Got a few fives.
Multiple fives. OK, John?
A 7.
What's your fives?
I got snide. And bodes.
OK, John?
I've got badness.
Susie, can I have badness?
Brilliant. It's in.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well, I did not expect that.
Could they have done better?
I've got anadesis.
I'm sorry to hear that, Danny. what have you got?
I've got anadesis.
And is the Cockney pronunciation of anodizes.
What?
What is that?
Anodizes is to coat the metal with a protective oxide layer, which is what we were talking about.
OK, so 7 points to John there. At the end of that, Sean and Jason have 7 points. John and Rod have 14 points.
Oh,
Now time for Jason and Rod to go head-to-head. This numbers round is just for you guys. Jason, you're to pick the numbers.
One big one and five little ones, I think.
Surely he has an advantage if he gets to pick the numbers, shouldn't he?
Well, you did last time.
Did I?
Yeah.
OK, so one large and five little ones. And for this round, they are 10, 1,
Phew.
4, 3, 2, and the large one, 25. Ugh. And the target, 818.
OK, your time starts now. Jason, what do you get?
I think I've got 818.
OK, that's ideal. Rod?
It's close. But... No, I'll have to hand it to you, I think, if you've got 818.
What did you get?
How could you not know what you've got? What have you...
I've got 27 so far, but I haven't finished.
Jason, tell us how you got 818.
Right. 4 plus 1.
That's just 5.
Times 25.
Oh,
times
now you're talking.
25 is
125. Is it? That may change
what
things.
What should it be?
What did you think it was?
Hold on. No, I've done it wrong.
How wrong are you? I think it would be
like
more...
by about 800.
In that case, can I come in with like 805 and win this?
No.
Why?
Too far away.
What if I stand over there?
Okay, so no points there. Rachel, could it be done?
Yeah, this one could be done. You could have said 25 plus 1 is 26, times by 3 is 78, add 4 is 82, times by 10 for 820, and take away the 2.
818. Time to go to Dictionary Corner. Danny, you're well known for your unique use of the English language, especially in your tweets. I've got some of your tweets here. I was wondering if you could explain some of them.
Go on, eh?
Okay. This is one of your recent tweets. Fuck it. I'm going to get ducked up to fuck. Me and my little sonny are going to treat him to a nice bit of stale bread. Hashtag old school.
Yeah, I took that to a nice little pond.
OK. I get the setup of the situation. You're going to feed the ducks. It's the next tweet that really confused me. It was, well, that was weird. Found a lovely pond stroke lake, not a fucking duck inside. Maybe they were shy, or maybe they was arrogant, pricks. You've just called to...
I don't know what to say to the little one. You know what I mean? I said, listen, we're going to go and feed the ducks. You got excitable, and there was no ducks. I don't know what to do. You know, where was I?
Well, what you don't say is, yeah, the thing is, darling, those ducks are arrogant pricks.
Cockneys like to see ducks because ducks are fucking mallard.
OK, the scores at the moment are Sean and Jason have 7, Rod and John are on 14. And here's your teaser. Here's your teaser. The words are lube tits and the clue is making things easier. That's lube tits making things easier. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were lube tits, and the clue was making things easier. It was, of course, subtitle. Before we move on, Rachel, you've been working very hard this evening, so I think it's about time we brought you out an assistant. Please welcome Rachel's assistant for the evening, Joe Wilkinson.
You all right?
Yep. Yeah.
Joe, why are you dressed like that?
Well, when they asked me to be on the show, I thought, well, surely they're not doing Countdown again. So I wrongly assumed I was going to be on Gladiators. So I'm absolutely gutted.
So I can see these are fake.
No, that's the only real bit. That's
is that
the
real? Only real.
What is most gutted, I've had me Gladiator name bung on the back, which is a pickled egg. So, I'm absolutely gutted. Can you hold that a sec? Look, I was hoping to meet Wolf. I was hoping to get him to sign my the scrapbook of him I've been making for the last 15 years. Got a clump of his hair.
I don't ask how you got that.
It was in Milton Keynes at the time. He didn't have a restraining order out on me.
Imagine he got it from his plug hole.
Can I cut a bit of your hair off?
I'd rather you didn't.
I'll do it later when she's sleeping.
You know when you said you thought you were going to be on Gladiators, did you think footwear would be provided, or is that what you said?
It's like you've been invited somewhere that says smart casual.
Now, you're Rachel's PA. How is she as a boss?
Very, very particular about the things, you know, like the length of the mini skirt she makes me wear. If that's too long, that comes off and I have to do the admin in my pants.
I normally make him wear pasties if he's going to have his nipples out as well.
Oh, they're out. I do apologise.
You make him wear what, sorry?
Pasties. It's one of Susie's words. She teaches me loads of words about nipples.
Pasties?
Pasties. So they're nipple tassels.
The nipple tassels
like
are called...
They go on your areola. Yeah.
Am I awake now?
So, hang on. How often do you two talk about nipples, then?
Well, they come up quite often.
They do.
No, but, I mean...
OK. Sean and Jason, your turn to choose the letters.
I can't even remember where we are now. Well, we'll have a consonant.
I'll do these. You can have a marrow.
Oh, lovely.
Got a load of them. I've got a job lot.
Shall I just sit?
So what do you want?
Consonant.
Consonant.
A vowel.
One of them.
Another consonant. And another one.
M.
Yeah, a vowel.
All right.
It's going to be tough on this. We better take another vowel. We've only got one.
A.
And then another consonant.
That's no. It's harder than it looks, mate.
I know.
Another consonant.
Now, how many do I have to do?
Another vowel.
Ah, you're getting a consonant.
That dash can be used as an I. Your time starts now. Jason, how many letters?
Five.
Five, okay. Sean?
Nine.
John?
Seven.
Rob?
When I say that? Five. I felt like it. I made thoughts to myself, probably feels really good to say nine. But it doesn't feel so good when you know you haven't got a nine.
At least I said it. At least I had the experience of going nine.
Rod, how many do you have?
Five.
Right, OK, Rod, what was your five?
Dicks.
The plural of penis.
I've got five as well.
Sean, you got five? Got
music.
You got music?
Yeah.
Okay, Jason, what was your five?
Dex.
John, you're seven.
Well, I... It's a word where I'm from, but I don't think it's a word.
We're going to talk about this later, Joe.
I've got duckies, as in I took my child to see the duckies, but it turned out they were all arrogant pricks.
Duckies. Can they have duckies?
Fantastic, yeah. Amazing. Well done. Well
done. 7 points to John. Danny, could they have done any better than duckies?
No, that was it. No, I mean, that was good. That sucked me, wasn't it?
Okay, so at the end of that, I can tell you that Jason and Sean have 7 points. John and Rod away in the lead with 21. On to another numbers round. Okay, John and Rod, your turn to pick the numbers.
You can have one big, two big, three big, or four big.
Four big, please.
Oh, this is crazy. Okay.
Can you do me honest?
Yeah, really love
marrow,
to.
Don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll do.
No. Okay.
What's it going to be?
101.
1. 10. 5. This is going to be really hard.
Sorry?
Who picked this one?
Oh, I feel sick.
What's going to be really hard?
Okay, what are they going for?
Good luck.
Do you want to read it or should I read it?
Bloody hell!
564.
Okay, your time starts now. Yeah. Jason and Sean, you got it?
Oh, no!
I got 575.
Yeah, that's what I've got, so 575. Okay.
More than 10 away. John, Rod?
574.
John, what have you got?
Well, I don't think I've got it, but I'll say 565 and see if I can make it up at the time.
You might as well
say
564, mate, to be honest.
OK, 565.
No, but if you haven't got it, you might as well say the number.
Oh, no, I've
got it. Go on, John.
Well, let's just say 100... divided by 25.
100 divided by 25 is 4.
I'll tell you what was going to happen if there'd been more numbers, right?
If Rod got it, why is not he doing it?
I don't know, but I don't think Rod's got it, has he?
No, Rod got 574. I say Rod, me.
It was going to be 4 plus 50 is 54, times 10 is 540.
Yeah.
And then I was going to do... Yeah, if the 75 had been another 25, I would have added that on. It would have been 565. I'd have taken the one off. People would have gone fucking mad.
So, Rod, could
what,
you...
Me or Rod? Oh, Rod.
You're in contact with Rod, yes?
Yeah, I can get in touch with him. What do you want?
OK. Tell us how you got to 574.
He said he did 50 times 10.
50 yeah. times 10 is 50. 500.
plus 75.
575.
Minus 1.
574.
What you boys didn't do was do minus one.
That's 5 points to Rod and John. Thank you. Could that have been done?
Yeah, it was a hard one, though. If you say 100 minus 75 is 25.
Yep.
Times 25 is 625.
Yep, correct.
Minus 50 is 575, and then take away the 10 and the 1.
Well, the scores at the moment, Jason and Sean have 7 points, John and Rod have 26 points. They are in the lead. OK, time now to go back to Dictionary Corner. Danny, here's an interesting fact for you. Susie's written a book called How to Talk Like a Local from Cockney to Geordie.
Just wind up or this.
No, she's genuinely written a book about local dialect.
Oh, really?
Do you think people can learn how to talk like you?
Well, what do you mean? Do people learn that? Yeah, I'm just brought up like that, and I. It's like, it's just what I speak, so. Could you learn it, yeah.
The interesting fact in the book, Susie, is the people from sort of Danny's area can't do certain tongue twisters.
That's right.
Bollocks.
which one specifically can't they do?
OK.
Let's try one.
I have it written here.
OK.
Betty bought butter, but the butter was bitter, so Betty bought better butter to make the bitter butter better.
You could say that, right?
Fucking piece of piss. I'm going to do it quick or just say it?
No, just say it.
What, Betty bought butter, but the butter was bitter, so Betty bought better butter to make the bitter butter better.
Why would Cockney people find these difficult to say?
You did it brilliantly, but it's just because of what they call these glottal stops. A glottal stop is when you just shut down your vocal cords. But you know when you went, you actually pronounced the double T, did you do that deliberately for the tongue twister?
I couldn't tell you, girl, to be honest. Okay.
You have got a great glottis.
Have I got a nice glottis about me, have I?
I think we have another one. Let's try the other one.
Let's have a bang on the other one. I just want to put this to bed now.
Well, he's a professional actor.
Please be nice with this one,
okay? Go on, baby, go on.
I haven't written this one. I saw Susie sitting in a shoe shine shop. Where she sits, she shines. And where she shines, she sits.
See, I know what you want me to do here. It's obvious. I saw Susie sitting in the shoe shine shop. Where she sits, she shines. And where she shines, she fucking shits.
I think it's because you're a trained actor, you've got that kind of... Right, you can
see,
do the lines.
I'm not trained. Not trained.
That explains a lot. And here is your final teaser. The words are arse prod and the clue is pop it in a hole. That's arse prod, pop it in a hole. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were arse prod and the clue was pop it in a hole. It was, of course, eardrops. OK, time for your final letters game. John and Rod, your turn to choose.
I'll have four vowels and four consonants, please.
OK, let's get going.
and then you need one something else.
I can only think of vowels and consonants.
You got five consonants. I made your decision for you.
Does anyone mind if I eBay that?
And your time starts now.
Rachel's head's in front of her letters.
I don't think I've got them all. Are you like the Cruella de Vil of cats?
Go on. What have you got, Jason?
Six.
Okay. Sean?
Seven.
John?
Well, I ain't got anything because someone got a lot of picking cats out.
Don't jump off. No.
I don't think you've thought this through, John.
God damn it, you.
I don't know if you've kept many pets, Jimmy, but kittens don't speak English. Don't jump off, kitten.
Ah, that one's gone. Sean, what was your word? What was your word, Sean? Sean, what was your word? Sean. What was your word?
Yes, well, no, what have they done? What's their crime?
They're in jail.
They're fine.
What I do?
Get back in! No! 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 What is your word, Sean? What's your word, Sean?
Tonads.
Jason, what's your
word? My word was tinned. By what they're going to be eating in a minute.
The cat's drinking your water, by the way.
What's your word? Because Jimmy's a bit preoccupied. What was your word,
Rob? My word is an eight. The only reason it's not going to work is that you can't have proper nouns and I've used an eight twice. Apart from that, it's Tanzania.
OK.
I've also got RSPCA written down here.
Danny and Susie could have done me better.
Donate, indent, they could have put them fucking things away, make my nerves bad.
OK, right. So Tinder's about as good as it gets. You've got 6 points there. Brilliant, OK. So Sean and Jason have 13 points. John and Rod have 26. This is your last chance to pick up points before the conundrum, Sean and Jason. Go ahead and pick your numbers.
Have the usual, please. Top and all the rest.
Yeah.
All the trimmings.
Do the five little ones?
All the trimmings.
How many have you got?
Just keep going.
No, that'll do, that'll do. That's enough. They go there. They go there.
So I think two.
Ooh, 12.
Not two.
Oh, I sometimes bloody wonder how much Joe really helps you.
He's just here for eye candy, isn't he?
What's going on here?
She's got a point.
You ready for this? 128.
OK, your time starts now. So the target was 128. Sean, Jason, how'd you do?
Yeah, got it.
Great.
128.
Yeah. Okay. John, Rod?
128.
128. Okay. Jason, show us, how did you do?
50 times 2. Sure.
50 times 2 is
That equals 100.
Well played.
Right. And then I've not got it. I just thought I'd try and blag it this time.
Have you not got it again?
I've not had it once. What are you on about?
Do it again.
Bung in a couple of threes.
Yeah, all right. 3 plus 3.
106.
No, 3 plus 3 plus 1.
Does a 4 help?
Is, 3 plus 3 plus 1.
What do you need?
Is 7.
John, how did you get it?
I said 3 plus 3 plus 1 is 7.
Nearly.
That's what I thought.
Times by 2 is 14.
Oh, oh. 7.
Okay.
Times by 2 is 14.
Times by 2. He's not pissing about now. Equals 14.
Add the 50 is 64, and then times by the other 2.
Good luck. Well done. Very good.
Full marks to John. So I can tell you the scores going into today's countdown conundrum are Jason and Sean have 13 points, John and Rod have 36 points. So Jason and Sean, you're playing for your pride now, really.
That's gone.
That's gone, is it?
Yeah, that's long gone.
Fingers on buzzers. It's time for today's countdown conundrum.
Oh, buzzer there. Yeah.
I've got it.
Joe, Sean, have you got it?
Shadowing.
OK, let's have a look.
Ah, oh, well played.
Sean's got it. Shadowing.
I think I looked at it, but it was second. Where's your button?
I actually got it straight away, and I thought, oh, that's all right. I don't get things like this. To be wrong. I had to check about 6 times in my head.
You get 10 points.
Oh, that's fine. That's all right.
Scores are Sean and Jason have 23 points, but tonight's winners with 36 points are John and Rod. Congratulations, John and Rod. There's your teapot. That is what you've won. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you working at home. That's it from us. Good night.
more same time next week. And returning to 4 next week, Adam, Alex and Josh will be back with a brand new series of The Last Leg on a brand new day, Wednesdays at 10. Right, well, anyone that was just watching this thinking, oh, I wonder what that John Richardson would be like in a solo stand-up show, is about to find out.